Good morning. Thank you all for coming on this important and historic day. And I would ask, if you would, that we join in a moment of silence in memory of those who lost their lives on this day 17 years ago, if you would. Thank you very much, Rhea, for once again leading us in that beautiful song and with your beautiful voice, and God bless America indeed. Thank you, Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein, for your work for this department, and Acting Associate Attorney General Jesse Panuccio. They're partners indeed in the work that we do and leaders indeed. Thank you all for being here. At this very hour, 17 years ago, our country was changed forever. We had been struck with the deadliest attack on American soil since Pearl Harbor. Nearly 300,000 people lost their lives. More than 1,300 children became orphans. More than a dozen unborn children lost their fathers they would never meet. The magnitude of this evil was overwhelming. And it is still overwhelming to think about. But in response to this great evil, the American people responded as they always do, with goodness, heroism, determination. 19 terrorists infiltrated our borders, targeted innocent people for death, but hundreds of Americans worked together to save lives. The first responders performed one of the most heroic rescue missions in history. Hundreds of them gave their lives, saving others, including 72 law officers from 10 different agencies. The brave men and women on Flight 93 prevented another target from being hit that day and saved lives. I was across the street at the Supreme Court building that morning attending the annual judicial conference, as I will again Thursday. Those Flight 93 heroes may well have saved lives on Capitol Hill. Over the following months, people gave billions of dollars. Thousands joined the armed forces. I know young people who joined up, signed up on that day shortly thereafter. Thousands of them gave their lives. We must remember them today, too. And so we should remember the Department of Justice was at the center of much of the country's response. The country faced unprecedented security and legal challenges. At the time, we had no National Security Division. Much of the work was done in the Criminal Division. Some of you here this morning were here on 9/11 too. You participated firsthand. We are grateful for the work you did in those difficult days that followed. Today, we are better equipped, better prepared, and better organized. We have better laws, but there is more to be done, and our adversaries have not abandoned their goals. The terrorist threat did not begin on 9/11, neither did it end on September 12th. Over the last 17 years, terrorists have been able to inflict other smaller attacks upon us and our allies, from San Bernardino to Orlando to Brussels. But I am exceedingly proud of the relentless and effective work of our National Security Division and the entire Department of Justice. Since 9/11, this department has secured the convictions of over 580 defendants for terrorism or terrorism-related charges. Over the past 5 years, we have charged more than 160 foreign fighters, homegrown violent extremists, ISIS supporters in more than 45 districts around this country. This past Christmas, the FBI arrested a man who wanted to conduct terrorist attacks in San Francisco. And we're not letting up. The FBI currently has ongoing investigations in all 50 states. So I'm amazed, really, at how effective our team has been in preventing attacks and prosecuting terrorists before they can carry out their murderous aims. 17 years ago, few would have predicted that we would go so long without another attack on the scale of what happened in 9/11. I meet with the FBI director, Rod, and his counterterrorism team, and our National Security Division 3 mornings a week to discuss the terrorist threat and how it has changed. Today, it's often online. A terrorist in Alexandria, Egypt, can contact a sympathizer in Alexandria, Virginia. In a matter of seconds, they can plot attacks and carry them out within just a few hours. And so, now more than ever, we have to stay one step ahead of the terrorist at all times. After all, they only have to succeed once. We have to succeed every time. It's not enough to prosecute terrorism or punish terrorist acts after the fact. That was a national consensus. Our goal is now to prevent terrorism acts from ever happening. So we must be vigilant. The terrorists are still targeting us. Some seek to infiltrate this country. Others plot from afar. They want to intimidate and control us. They reject our culture, our free speech, our freedom of religion, our democratic life. They seek acquiescence and inaction on our part. But we will meet them with resolve. They seek to impose their speech codes, their religion, their ideology, but they will fail. We will not yield. We will never yield. Not yielding our freedom, our individual moral autonomy, or our country. We will steadfastly defend our institutions and our way of life. And so, as we return to our work at the department today, this anniversary should remind us how important our work is. There is no higher secular calling than to protect the safety, lives, and rights of our fellow citizens. All rights depend on that. As we continue our efforts, let us also remember the example of service and dedication that so many law officers and first responders set 17 years ago as they lay down their lives for their neighbors. And it's appropriate on this day of remembrance to pause to consider the role and importance of this historic and great Department of Justice in the life of the nation that we serve. And we serve more than a nation. We have a duty to millions of American people. We've been given a great legacy, a trust from the American people. Those here and serving 17 years ago understood and rose to that occasion with dedication and long hours facing great uncertainty, with judgment and courage, they met the challenge of their time. They held our banner high. Let us do likewise today and every day. We are honored to serve this great nation. Thank you all, and God bless America.